A shoot shall come from the sprout of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord. His delight shall be in the fear of the Lord. With righteousness he shall judge the poor and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. The wolf shall live with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the kid. The calf and the lion and the fatling together. And a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play over the hole of the asp, and the weaned child shall put his hand on the adder's den.
One day, when Francis went out to meditate in the fields, he walked near the church of San Damiano, which was threatening to collapse because of age. Impelled by the Spirit, he went inside to pray. Prostrate before an image of the crucified, he was filled with no little consolation as he prayed. While his tear-filled eyes were gazing at the Lord's cross, he heard within his bodily ears a voice coming from the cross, telling him three times, "Francis, go and repair my house, which, as you see, is all being destroyed." Trembling, Francis was stunned at the sound of such an astonishing voice, since he was alone in the church. And as he absorbed the power of the divine words into his heart, he fell into an ecstasy of mind. At last, coming back to himself, he prepared to obey and pull himself together to carry out the command of repairing the material church, although the principal intention of the words referred to that which Christ had purchased with his own blood, as the Holy Spirit taught him, and as he himself later disclosed to his brothers.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man who was named Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
According to St. Bonaventure, Francis placed himself and his order under the protection and guidance of Mary for all time. From one perspective, we can image Mary in all of her poverty of Bethlehem, placing the most sweet Son of God upon the rough straw of the manger. From another perspective, we would see Mary, the Immaculate Mother of God and Queen of the Seraphic Order, in the chapel of Mary of the Angels, stretching forth her arms in motherly protection over all her Franciscan sons and daughters. From his earliest days, according to Thomas of Celano, Francis burned with devotion toward the Mother of all good. When Francis abandoned the world, he placed himself under the loving care and protection of his Heavenly Mother. He asked her to be his guide and advocate in all his new life of poverty, after the pattern of her son.
O Holy Mary, Mother of God and our Blessed Mother, we turn to you to deepen our understanding of this holy mystery. Through your humble acceptance and loving embrace of the Word made flesh, guide us in pondering the Incarnation. As you were chosen and graced by God, lead us in faithfully responding to his call, embodying the love and humility of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
As drifted snow, his eyes as flame. All hail, said he, O lowly maiden Mary, most highly favored lady, glory. man's praise continually. Your son shall be Emmanuel, thy seers foretold. Most highly favored lady, Gloria. Then gentle Mary meekly bowed her head. To me be as it pleases God, she said. My soul shall loud and magnify his holy name. Most highly favored lady, Gloria. Of her Emmanuel the Christ was born. In Bethlehem all on a Christmas morn. And Christian folk throughout the world will ever say, most highly favored lady, Gloria.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered, and so all went to their towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver the child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Francis's highest aim, foremost desire, and greatest intention was to pay heed to the Holy Gospel in all things and through all things, in following the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to retrace his footsteps completely with all vigilance and all zeal, all the desire of his soul and all the fervor of his heart. Francis used to recall with regular meditation the words of Christ, and recollect his deeds with most attentive perception. Indeed, so thoroughly did the humility of the Incarnation and the charity of the Passion occupy his memory that he scarcely wanted to think of anything else.
Heavenly Father, lead us in our Advent meditations as we prepare for Christmas to allow our hearts and minds to be filled with gratitude for the humility of the Incarnation, and the charity of the Passion of your Son. May it lead us to desire in all things to follow his teachings and to retrace his footsteps. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray, amen. Now let us stand and see if we can join in the next hymn of O Holy Night.
Thank you.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger.
Near the time of the birthday of our Lord Jesus Christ, Francis said to a certain John from the area of Greccio, "Hurry before me and carefully make ready the things I tell you, for I wish to enact the memory of that babe who was born in Bethlehem, to see as much as possible with my own bodily eyes the discomfort of his infant needs, how he lay in a manger, and how, with an ox and an ass standing by, he rested on hay."
God of all creation, may our Advent prayer lead to a renewal of the true spirit of Bethlehem in our hearts and in our world. May the contemplation of the humility of our Lord at his birth lead us to follow him through moments of suffering and death, just as he humbly accepted death on the cross. We ask this through Christ, our redeeming Lord. Amen.
There's a star in the east on Christmas morn. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. It will lead to the place where Christ was born. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. Shepherd and follow the star of Bethlehem. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. If you take good heed to the angel's words, rise up, shepherd, and follow. You'll forget your flocks, you'll forget your herds. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. of shepherd and followed a star of Bethlehem. Rise up, shepherd and follow.
In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. And they told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them, when the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Once the good and faithful man had heard Francis's words, he ran quickly and prepared in that place all the things that the holy man had requested. Finally, the day of joy had drawn near. The time of exaltation had come. From many different places, the brethren had been called. As they could, the men and women of that land, with exultant hearts, prepared candles and torches to light up that night whose shining star has enlightened every day and year. Finally, the holy man of God came, and finding all things prepared, he saw them and was glad. Indeed, the manger was prepared, the hay carried in, and the ox and the ass were led to the spot. There, simplicity is given a place of honor, poverty exalted, humility commended, and out of Greccio is made a new Bethlehem.
God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, grant to us, your people, the grace to embrace peace with all of our hearts, and to become ourselves children of peace, and seekers of eternal salvation. May we be instruments of your peace, which is so needed in our world today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life. And life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it.
The hay placed in the manger there was preserved afterwards, so that through it the Lord might restore to health the pack animals and the other animals there, as he multiplied his holy mercy. It came to pass in the surrounding area that many of the animals, suffering from various diseases, were freed from their illnesses when they ate some of this hay. What is more, women who had been suffering with long and hard labor had an easy delivery after they placed some of this hay upon themselves. Finally, an entire group of people of both sexes obtained much desired relief from various afflictions.
Noche de paz, noche
Let's all stand. God of love, all creation sings your praise in this holy season. May our memory of that holy moment of the Word becoming flesh among us revive in us faith, hope, and charity. May we be effective in carrying your word in our hearts, so that just as the hay that Francis placed in that manger touched and brought healing to people and even to animals, so may our prayer this evening make us the instruments of your healing in our world for all those that we touch. We ask this humbly with the heart of Francis, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord. Amen. And now for a blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us all, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. We now invite you to come forward as we sing our final hymn and bring your candle with you to be placed on the altar. And then take some hay with you as an extension of St. Francis' blessing of peace and healing in our world. And after you have done this, you can make your way to the Perry Center for our social. So please come forward as the final hymn is sung.